Hello, folks. I am Alan for today's news. I'll be bringing you world news, interesting news, news to keep you entertained, and news to keep you informed. And didn't find a whole lot here, just found a few things. A lot of gardening tips if you're interested in that. Anyway, let me get on to here. This is from Reuters. Moscow will get no say in decision on Kyiv's NATO membership, says Norway.
By Sabine Siebold and Gladys Fouché. Oslo, Reuters, NATO will not allow Russia to decide when Ukraine can join the Western alliance, Norway said on Wednesday as it hosted NATO foreign ministers seeking to narrow divisions over Kyiv's membership bid before a July summit. It is for Ukraine and NATO allies to decide and Ukraine becomes a NATO member, it's not up to Moscow to decide, Norwegian Foreign Minister Anniken Huitfeldt told reporters on the eve of a two-day meeting with her NATO counterparts. The alliance has not acceded to Ukraine's request for fast-track membership as Western governments such as the US and Germany are wary of any move that might take the alliance closer to war with Russia. Kyiv and some of its closest allies in Eastern Europe want concrete steps to bring Ukraine closer to membership to be agreed when NATO leaders hold a summit on July 11th to 12th in Vilnius, Lithuania. Last week, NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg said Ukraine would not be able to join while the war with Russia raged but said that would be different when the conflict was over. NATO agreed in 2008 that Ukraine could eventually join the alliance but leaders have so far stopped short of steps, such as giving Kyiv a membership action plan, that would lay out a timetable for bringing Ukraine closer to the military pact. Russia is viscerally opposed to Ukraine joining NATO but its invasion of its neighbor triggered a historic policy shift by Finland, which joined NATO in April, reversing 7 decades of military non-alignment. Finland applied to join along with Sweden, whose entry has been held up by Hungary and Turkey, where the re-election of President Tayyip Erdogan at the weekend could bring fresh impetus to Stockholm's membership bid. Norway's Huitfeldt said Sweden should become a full member before NATO's July summit. There is absolutely no reason for holding Sweden back, she said. Sweden fulfills all the criteria. Progress in Oslo is unlikely, however, as Turkish Foreign Minister Mevlüt Cavusoglu will not be there.
And that's all I got on that one there. Let me go to my next one. This from Popper Mechanics. Italy may secretly be sending its tank hunters to Ukraine.
Rumors have flown on social media speculating, based on fragmentary evidence, that Rome may be secretly delivering some of its retiring B-1 Centauro tank destroyers to Ukraine. These nimble 8-wheeled armored cars have firepower comparable to the Leopard 1 tanks also entering Ukrainian service. The rumors were linked to footage of a train in Caserta, near Naples in southern Italy, transporting at least 4 Centauros north, followed by Iveco VM90 military trucks. But that's hardly proof that those B1s were bound for Ukraine, rather than for transport to an Italian base or international exercise. Convoys transporting vehicles for NATO exercises have been mistaken for aid to Ukraine before. And, notably, the lead vehicle on the train still has an Italian flag on its rear hull. Even the video's date is unclear. Those in support of the rumor argue that Rome has a policy of not publicizing its military assistance to Ukraine, which has been sustained in both the preceding center-left Draghi administration and the current far-right Meloni government. Despite the policy, Italian arms transfers to Ukraine are known to include different kinds of air defense batteries and radars. These include the powerful SAMP/T system built by France, an estimated 60 or so M109L self-propelled howitzers, valuable PZH-2000 and M270A1 long-range artillery systems, heavy mortars and FH-70 towed howitzers, and various trucks, infantry weapons, and other gear. The B-1 Centauro has long been seen as a plausible donation for Ukraine, as the Italian army is replacing the 259 B-1s in its 9 cavalry regiments with harder-hitting Centauro 2s. It's alleged that the Centauros on the train were refurbished in the same facility used to prepare M109LS that were given to Ukraine. Overall, though, the present rumors are too thinly sourced to be afforded much confidence. Nonetheless, as the Italian army is retiring the type, it's still possible that the Centauros may end up in Ukrainian service sooner or later. Like the French AMX-10RC armored cars entering service with Ukraine, they would be at risk to many tank-killing weapons at the frontline. However, they could provide effective, accurate, and highly mobile fire support for operations along roads and relatively open ground, of which there is plenty in Ukraine. If Centauros end up seeing combat in Ukraine, it will be under very different circumstances than their first frantic engagement 30 years earlier known as, we are not making this up, the Battle of Checkpoint Pasta. Italy's tank-hunting armored car. Italy's armored cars and self-propelled guns were considered better than its tanks during World War II. The B-1 Centauro continues the legacy of both. Like Japan's Type 16 maneuver combat vehicle, it combines the firepower of a tank with lighter armor and wheels instead of tracks, making it easier to rapidly airlift further afield.
And there's more to read if you want to read the rest of this. I'm going to my next one here. This one here from Alcazes. UAE withdraws from U.S.-led maritime coalition.
The United Arab Emirates has withdrawn from a United States-led maritime coalition after an extensive evaluation of its security needs, its Ministry of Foreign Affairs says. As a result of our ongoing evaluation of effective security cooperation with all partners, 2 months ago, the UAE withdrew its participation in the combined maritime forces, the ministry said on Wednesday in a statement quoted by state news agency WAM. The UAE also said it was committed to dialogue and diplomatic engagement to advance regional security and stability as well as ensuring navigation safety near its shores in accordance with international law. The decision marks a pivotal moment in the region's geopolitical landscape, altering the dynamics of international cooperation in maritime security. The 34-nation task force headquartered at the U.S. Naval Base in Bahrain was formed to counter terrorism and piracy in the Red Sea and Gulf areas. The region contains some of the world's most important shipping routes, and since 2019, there have been a series of attacks on vessels at times of tension between the U.S. and Iran. The UAE, with its strategic position along vital maritime trade routes, had been an active participant in the U.S.-led coalition. Iranian threat. Earlier in May, the U.S. said it would bolster its defensive posture in the Gulf as Washington accused Tehran of carrying out increased attacks on commercial shipping. Iran seized two international oil tankers in late April and early May in the Strait of Hormuz, including the Niovi, which had been traveling from Dubai towards the UAE port of Fujairah.
And you can read the rest of this in my description box too. There's a lot more to read here. I'm going to my next one. It's from Marcus Insider. Russian energy giant Gazprom's private security force was deployed to fight in Ukraine, reports this.
Gazprom's private security companies have forces fighting in the Ukraine war, the Wall Street Journal said. The energy giant got the go-ahead to establish a security force in February. I want to tell my colleagues at Gazprom, don't go to Ukraine, stay at home. Full screen. Russia's state-owned energy company Gazprom now supplies more than just natural gas. According to the Wall Street Journal, it is actively helping provide manpower to the front lines of Russia's war on Ukraine. First authorized by the Kremlin to do so in early February, the energy giant has spent recent months establishing private security companies and recruiting additional troops for Russia's war, often fighting under the directive of the Defense Ministry. Though the security firms were founded on the pretext of defending Russia's energy sector, recruits ended up in Ukraine weeks later, Wall Street Journal reported. Some in the group, made up of former soldiers and company security personnel, were forcibly recruited, adding they were trained at a Russian base, and shipped off to Bakhmut, the area of eastern Ukraine that has seen the fiercest fighting in recent months. I want to tell my colleagues at Gazprom, don't go to Ukraine, stay at home, a former Gazprom security guard, who was sent to Ukraine and was injured, said in a video obtained by Wall Street Journal. The company didn't immediately respond to Insider's request for comment. Gazprom didn't respond to the journal's request for comment. Compared to the Wagner Group, a private militia of 50,000 that has played a significant role in Russia's military effort, Gazprom's collective force is smaller, accounting for thousands of recruits. However, they are paid higher wages and tend to be better trained. The energy firm's efforts may also provide some solution to Russia's growing manpower shortage, as President Vladimir Putin seems reluctant to issue another mobilization decree, the Wall Street Journal said. That's after an October mobilization of 300,000 recruits led to a mass exodus of citizenry out of Russia, contributing to a record labor shortage in the country. But interest in private security groups is growing in Russia, with other mercenary forces fighting in Ukraine. This includes recruits from former security contractor Redut, and from Patriot, an established private security force. Meanwhile, Gazprom has had a difficult year in energy markets, as the Ukraine war led to Western sanctions and restricted trade. Last year, the Kremlin also cut off Europe from most gas supplies delivered via pipeline, though Russia still exports liquefied natural gas. In January, the company said revenue was nearly $3 billion lower than in the previous year.
And that's all I got on that one there. Let me go to my next one. Anything I have on here will be in my description box, just so you know. This is from Newsweek. Ukrainian forces fire on retreating Wagner troops leaving Bakhmut.
Ukrainian forces have inflicted casualties on Russian Wagner Group forces withdrawing from the city of Bakhmut, a spokesperson for Ukraine's armed forces has said. Sergei Cherevadiy said clashes in the city in Ukraine's eastern Donetsk region have significantly decreased, but that Ukraine had killed 80 Wagner Group fighters and wounded a further 119 as they retreated from Bakhmut. The Russian paramilitary group's chief, Yevgeny Prigozhin, announced in a video message on May 25 that Wagner mercenaries had begun their retreat from the embattled city of Bakhmut and that they will completely withdraw by June 1, giving way to regular Russian units. Prigozhin's fighters had been involved in a bloody battle for Bakhmut since the summer in 2022. Their recent withdrawal came after Prigozhin released several videos aimed at Russian Defense Minister Sergei Shoigu and Chief of the General Staff Valery Gerasimov, accusing them of intentionally depriving his fighters of ammunition. Prigozhin said in an interview with pro-Moscow blogger Konstantin Dolgov published on May 23 that the Wagner Group had lost thousands of fighters in the battle for Bakhmut. Throughout the Bakhmut operation, I recruited 50,000 prisoners, of which about 20% died. Exactly the same number died as those who signed up through a contract, Prigozhin said.
And you can read the rest of this in my description box. I'm going to the next one now. Okay, this is from the Cooldown. Gardner shares life-changing hack for removing unwanted plants from your garden. That is so smart.
A recent TikTok hack is eliminating the need for extra garden tools, using a common household item to uproot pesky plants and weeds from the garden. The Scoop. The TikTok account for the family-owned garden center and nursery, Smith's Garden Town, at Smith's Garden Town, shares tips on everything gardening, from taking care of your plants to tree recommendations to garden-friendly bugs. One of the users sponsored content. More.
Okay. Let me play this one video here. Can you find it? Anyway, there was a video on it. Let's see, let me refresh this.
This time with pliers.
Okay, it just rained today, so that's the ticket for this working. I've got a pecan sapling here growing in my catmint, which is starting to bloom. So take your pliers, find this base of this plant, and I'll do that. Pull it. I didn't find the base of it. That was a problem. Pull it up. And you get the whole taproot like that. So when you have those deep-rooted tree saplings like this hackberry, right after the rain, find them. This one might take two hands. Let's see. And you can pull the whole sapling up because the ground is so saturated. I mean, that root is 18 inches long and comes right out of the ground.
So you wait until the ground gets saturated or you wet it down and you take a pair of pliers and just grab the plant by its crown and just pull it up, root and all. Let me go to my next one. That's from the Associated Press. U.S. military complains of unsafe, aggressive move by Chinese fighter jet.
Washington, AP, the U.S. military said Tuesday that a Chinese fighter jet flew aggressively close to a U.S. reconnaissance aircraft over the South China Sea, forcing the American pilot to fly through the turbulent wake. The Chinese J-16 fighter pilot flew directly in front of the nose of the RC-135, which was conducting routine operations in international airspace last Friday, U.S. Indo-Pacific Command said in a statement. It called the Chinese move an unnecessarily aggressive maneuver. U.S. defense leaders have complained that China's military has become significantly more aggressive over the past 5 years, intercepting U.S. aircraft and ships in the region. And tensions with China have only grown in recent months over Washington's military support and sales of defensive weapons to self-governing Taiwan, China's assertions of sovereignty to the contested South China Sea, and its flying of a suspected spy balloon over the U.S. In a further sign of the tensions, China said its defense chief will not meet with U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin when the two men attend a security conference in Singapore this coming weekend. Austin is scheduled to address the Shangri-La dialogue on Saturday, while Chinese Defense Minister General Li Shangfu will speak at the gathering on Sunday.
Okay, let me see, let's watch this video here. There's no sound. You can see the Chinese fighter jet there crossing the path of our jet. And the turbulence bounced the pilot around a little bit. They want to start a war. Anyway, I'm going to go on my next one. You can read the rest of this in my description box if you like. This one from my Den Garden. Daughter dumps hydrogen peroxide in mom's ear, and what crossed out is the stuff of nightmares.
If this happened to me, I would simply pass away. Seriously, I can't watch this too many times or my ear starts itching just out of pure fear. If you've got bug phobias, you might want to skip this one. This TikTok user's mom felt something moving around in her ear, and so her daughter decided to help her out and see what was going on. You will never guess what they found. Click here to watch the video. When Edmunimarin's mom felt a weird sensation in her ear, she wasn't sure what it was. Apparently she had been standing outside under a tree branch and had felt something fall on her ear. She brushed it off and thought she had gotten it out. Only to find, 30 minutes later once she was back inside her house, that an entire living spider was still alive inside of her ear. Shudders. Immediately she ran to get her daughter to try and figure out a solution. She tried a Q-tip at first but was afraid she might kill the bug and it would die inside of my head. The daughter saved the day by pouring some hydrogen peroxide into her mom's ear, and immediately the spider popped right out. Oh my god, it was so big. Her viewers are completely freaked out and so were we. Absolutely not, wrote at Michaela Francois. New fear unlocked flushed face, commented at Breaking Brit. User at Redabena29 added, not my ear being itchy as soon as the spider crawled out loudly crying face dot. Hydrogen peroxide was a great idea, because it was a perfect way to flush out the bug while not causing any harm to the mom's ear. This solution is usually used as a mild antiseptic, preventing infections for cuts, but it also can be used to remove mucus. For bugs specifically, hydrogen peroxide can kill most insects and their eggs, so this was an excellent choice to get that freaky thing out. It might take me a while to get over this one. Watch me buy earplugs, headphones, ear muffs, whatever I can to make sure this never happens to me.
Things kind of funny. Anyway, I'm gonna play some video, so if you think it might bother you, you might want to not watch this.
Why do you think it's going to bubble? Because it bubbles when you put it on blood.
No, it bubbles when you put it on earwax.
It does?
Yep.
Ah, shit, that's cold.
No, see? Yeah, it came out. I told you.
What came out?
It's a... Yeah,
look. It's a spider? Oh, my God! Ah!
I told you that would come out. Jesus
what
you Christ.
What
eggs? That's fucking disgusting.
I
mean,
laid eggs.
Let go of me. What
are
you...
Okay, I might have to mute that or mute a part of it. Otherwise, I get in trouble from YouTube. Let me go to the next one. They're from USA Today. False claim, Trump increased debt more than any president. Fact check.
The claim, Trump increased the debt far more than any president in history. A May 17th Facebook post, direct link, archive link, shows a black and white image of several members of Congress gathered together. The post criticized Republicans for attacks on the poor and the sick with the threat of catastrophic debt default, then made a claim about former President Donald Trump. Start the day smarter. Get all the news you need in your... Trump increased that debt far more than any president in history, the post says in part. Under Trump, Republicans minus and Democrats minus had no objection to raising the debt ceiling three times. House Minority Leader Hakeem Jeffries shared a similar claim on Twitter that garnered over 11,000 likes. A version of that post was posted on Facebook by the left-wing account Occupy Democrats and shared more than 900 times. Our rating, false. The total federal debt increased more under the Obama administration in terms of raw dollars than any other president, according to government data. Experts say it is difficult to determine how much debt one president is responsible for since spending and policies can carry over from one administration to the next. Obama incurred more debt than any other president. The post comes after weeks of standstill between President Joe Biden and House Speaker Kevin McCarthy over the issue of raising the debt ceiling, which limits how much the government can borrow, as USA Today reported. But contrary to the post's claim, the total federal debt increased more under former President Barack Obama than it did under the Trump administration, according to David Primo, a political science and business administration professor at the University of Rochester. There are different ways of measuring debt, experts said. Using Treasury Department data, the total public debt, which includes intergovernmental holdings and public debt, increased by approximately $7.8 trillion from the start of Trump's presidency on January 20, 2017, to when he left office on January 19, 2021. Under Obama, however, the public debt increased by about $9.3 trillion from when he was inaugurated on January 20, 2009, to when he left office on January 19, 2017.
Okay, Obama, he incurred more debt. And after Biden gets out, you're going to hear Biden's broke the record. Let me go to the next one here. This is from Bloomberg. Suspected state-backed hackers hit series of new targets.
Bloomberg. A hacking group suspected of ties to an Asian government has broadened its targets to government agencies in countries including Indonesia and Thailand, carrying out cyber espionage as recently as April, cybersecurity firm Group IB says. The perpetrators, dubbed Dark Pink by the Singapore-based company, infiltrated five new targets using sophisticated malware and phishing emails. Their victims included government agencies in Brunei and Indonesia, a military body in Thailand, a nonprofit organization in Vietnam, and an educational institution in Belgium. The five targets joined eight previously identified targets across Southeast Asia and Europe, Group IB said in a report published Wednesday. Government and military organizations are prime targets for hackers given the confidential and sensitive data on their networks. Phishing emails are the top threat in Asia, a region that endured the highest number of cyber attacks in the world last year, comprising nearly a third of all global attacks, according to IBM Security's annual threat index. The government and military agencies in the specified countries didn't respond to emailed requests for comment. There is mounting evidence suggesting that Dark Pink is not a one-time campaign carried out by a known APT group, but rather a distinct and continuously evolving threat, Group IB malware analyst Andrei Polovinkin said, referring to advanced persistent threats or stealthy cyber attacks often sponsored by a government. The risk of highly damaging confidential data leaks remains alarmingly high.
Okay, they're after governments. Let me go ahead and let this read the rest of it.
While Dark Pink's exact identity hasn't been confirmed, researchers say it most likely originates from the Asia-Pacific given the location of the targets and evolving sophistication of its methods, including advanced malware built into a program posing as a Microsoft Word file. It was previously reported to have begun its hacking campaign in June 2021, and to have stolen documents and recorded audio from infected devices. In addition to the latest April attack on an Indonesian government agency, Group IB researchers identified updated files from Dark Pink as recently as May, suggesting the group has continued its work. Chinese researchers from the Zhejiang-based firm DAS Security also attributed attacks by the same group on the Philippine military, Cambodia's economy and finance ministry, and Indonesia's foreign ministry. DAS Security said the hackers, which they labeled the SAFE group, were geopolitically motivated. That's because of its covert targeting of Association of Southeast Asian Nation countries' military and foreign ministry departments, it said in a February report. With assistance from Jamie Tarabay. Updates with attack details in sixth paragraph. A previous version of this story was corrected to say hackers infiltrated five new targets rather than five new nations.
And that's all I got on that one there. So it's coming as a Microsoft Word program, a file. Be careful getting into them, your emails. Let me go on the next one here. This from the Den Garden. Man shares how he made his own irrigation system using only a plastic bottle. I thought it was pretty cool.
Your plants will thank you. Magdalena Mercy. May 31st, 2023, 11:32 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. If you have a green... Basically what we are creating here is a mini DIY irrigation system. If you're unfamiliar with that term, irrigation... If you have a green thumb but are a bit on the lazy side, this hack was literally made for you. Remembering to water your plants, especially if you have a lot of plant babies, can be a tough job. Even if you have reminders and timers set on your phone, sometimes we get caught up in another task and forget to nourish these poor things. TikTok user at Joe's Garden has the perfect trick for keeping your plants nice and healthy that won't require a ton of checking in. This hack is a win-win because not only are you helping your plants grow, but you're helping the planet. All you need is an empty plastic water bottle, which we all have lying around somewhere. So much better to put it to use than tossing it. Review of the Brigii M1 handheld vacuum. Viet Don. Basically what we are creating here is a mini DIY irrigation system. If you're unfamiliar with that term, irrigation systems supply water to crops and plants typically through pipes or sprinklers, rather than just rainfall or watering by hand. These save us a ton of labor and time, because we can have our plants be watered continuously, even when we're not there.
And I think I'm gonna try this winter. We have some plants inside here, and I overwater them and killed them. And let me see what this video area is right here.
From the bottle, instead of just throwing this away,
keep a couple of spare bottles and grab some cotton swabs. Carefully poke a hole in the bottom of the bottle and the other one in the cap. Using your cotton swabs, snip them both in half and then put one in the bottom hole and the other one in the top. Fill up your bottle with water and droplets will start to fall from the bottom swab. You can remove the swab from the top to speed up these droplets. What you've created is a drip irrigation system that will help you water your plants on autopilot. Thank you so much for watching and please follow for more.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea. Let me go to the next one here. This from Den Garden also. Man shares how he made his very own irrigation. Oh no, I already showed that one. Okay, let me go to the next one. Oh, my last one here. This from the Cooldown. Farmers share the surprising kitchen ingredient that will help your garden thrive. It's like magic for plants.
A TikTok user has shared their helpful hack for encouraging root growth and preventing fungi in your garden, and all it takes is a little cinnamon. The scoop. In a recent TikTok, user Christina, at ThermalandOaks, shares her cinnamon-based tip for keeping your garden happy and healthy. I want to let you know a little tip. Did you know that cinnamon is like magic for plants? She asks. Let me tell you why. All you have to do is sprinkle a little bit on top, and this will encourage root growth. And because it has antifungal properties, it will prevent mold and fungus from growing on your starters. She sprinkles cinnamon all over her container of starter plants. One last thing, be sure to let the solid completely dry out before you water it again once you put cinnamon in. How it's helping. According to Talk Leisure, cinnamon acts as a rooting hormone because it contains cinnamaldehyde, which encourages plants to produce auxin. Auxin is a hormone that causes cells to elongate and divide, which helps roots to form and grow. Gardening know-how also explained that cinnamon's antifungal properties help stave off problems such as damping off disease and slime mold. Christina's cinnamon hack helps the plants in your garden take firm roots and stay healthy by protecting them from fungal problems. Maintaining a fruitful garden can help you save money on produce at the grocery store. Gardens also improve the quality of air and soil around your home, according to Green Matters. What everyone's saying. Users shared their excitement about Christina's hack and expressed their thanks in the comments section of her TikTok. We will definitely be doing this, one user wrote. It works, another user said. What? Amazing. I'll try it, thank you, a third user commented.
Okay, now we're going to watch this video here.
Hey, I want to let you in on a little tip. Did you know that cinnamon is like magic for plants? Can you hear all the donkeys? Let me tell you why. All you have to do is sprinkle a little bit on top, and this will encourage root growth. And because it has antifungal properties, it will prevent mold and fungus from growing on your starters. So I'm just going to sprinkle it everywhere on here. One last thing. Be sure to let the soil completely dry out before you water it again once you put cinnamon in, and I hope this helps. Follow for more tips.
Yeah, I'm going to try that. I transplanted some strawberry plants and from runners, and they didn't look very well. They're starting to get a little bit better. We took them out of the sun. Anyway, that's all I got for you today. I hope I got something you can use. And don't forget to like, subscribe, or at least come back once in a while. And until next time, thanks for watching.